photos were pretty good as well, weren't they? So wonderful, isn't it? Just to see the young ones being encouraged and given an opportunity. They did so, so well. Fraser did it especially for his grandma today, so I'm sure she probably sat and bubbled all the way through. She did. Oh dear. Well, we're going to move on. I actually have the privilege of speaking today. I'm just going to speak very briefly. Normally it's Duncan, but I never get to speak at a Christmas service, so really excited to do that. And then we're going to move on to all our various fun items that are going to be taking place. But first of all, this is such a busy, who's been stressed out? You know, it's hectic, isn't it? Those of you that were here last Sunday would have heard how I sat for ages, hours, writing out all my Christmas cards, only for my husband to come along and kick a great big mug of coffee all over the mall, and how I screamed and didn't say the nicest, most pleasant things. And, you know, there's just so much pressure and it gets hectic, isn't there? Isn't it, at this time? But it's also a time that there's great excitement, great anticipation, you know, and it's a good time of year, isn't it? And it's a time of year that we can really celebrate. And at this time of the year, there's probably so many things that you're all expecting. You're maybe expecting to receive something. You're maybe hoping that special thing is going to be under your Christmas tree on that morning. You know, maybe you're just hoping that something special is going to happen and you're going to get the very item of your dream. So before I start to share today, I've got some gifts here that I just think might be the very thing that some of you are really hoping for this Christmas. So let's see. First of all, I've got something here for Valerie. Now, I know Valerie is very into style and fashion, and I'm sure, Valerie, if you'd like to come, please, that what I have in here is just what she's longing for under her Christmas tree. Come on, let's give it up for Valerie. She likes to be with it, and she likes the latest stuff. You turn around here so they can all see you open this, Valerie. She likes the latest stuff. So let's see what's in. You have to open it and show them, because maybe some of you are longing for this under your tree. Under your Christmas tree. Take that home, I'm sure your husband will be delighted. Right. Let's see. Now, I think that there's someone here who really what they would just like for Christmas is lots of love and lots of hugs and kisses. So I think that this is what Conrad would be hoping for under his Christmas tree. So Conrad, come, and this is for you. And you can show us. You're all hoping for something. Is this maybe what you're hoping for on Christmas Day? Let's see. They're showered with kisses. Maybe that's just what you're looking for. Now, I'm sure ladies, I am sure there are many ladies here today that this is the very thing that they are absolutely longing for. So I think my sister-in-law Linda would love to find this under her tree on Christmas morning, because we're always ribbing her about this. Linda, come and open your present. Most ladies would love to have this. Gentlemen, if you've not been shopping yet, this is a clue what you can buy your wife or your partner for Christmas morning. Diamonds! How many of you? Dennis, I've been waiting too long. You don't have to thank me, it's not real, Linda. No, and I've got one last one. Now, there's somebody who's always saying to me, Kath, all I want is it. Give me a makeover. Nominate me for Extreme Makeover. And we're always joking, he's always wanting to have new teeth, a six pack, all this kind of stuff. Guys, who would this be that's always a Scott? Come! Because after he's cheated, what you do. Scott, on one condition, this you actually have to put on and let us see. Now turn around. Scott's always wanting to up his image. said, he's always wanting all these treatments any time we speak about these programs. But this spot is an instant fix, and this is going to change everything for you in a moment. So if you'd like to open up this and pop it on, we would be delighted. Don't hear it, Scott. It's expensive. Right? Just one moment till we're getting ready. All right. Scott's image problems are all over. Turn around. Scott, on Christmas morning. You know, I'm sure, we were saying to Caroline and Alec last night, Alec says, I'm not getting her anything because she says she wants nothing. I once said that to Duncan, and you all know what happened. I got the very thing I asked for, and it was nothing. I never spoke to him for a month. We're all longing for something, and I'm just going to look briefly at two Bible characters today, and I'm just going to share with you what they were looking for, what they were longing for, and what they were expecting. Now, these two Bible characters, we don't often hear about them at Christmas time, but yet they play a vital part in the Christmas story. And one is a man called Simeon, and the other is a lady called Anna. I've never seen them in any of the nativity scenes. I've never seen them on any of the Christmas cards, but yet they're really, really key people. You see, Simeon and Anna, they, like you, they were waiting and waiting. They were expecting, eagerly and anticipating that special something. But they weren't waiting for diamonds, or they weren't waiting for the latest animal print catwalk fashion, or they weren't waiting for a new makeover. What they were waiting for was someone. And in the book of Luke, which I'm just going to read to you briefly, it speaks about a word, it's a Greek word, that means that they were waiting with expectation for the coming of the Saviour, who we know Christmas is all about, the baby Jesus. It literally means, the Greek word that's used through this passage of scripture, it means that they were alert to his appearance and they were ready to welcome him. So I'm going to read to you just briefly, if you can all stay with me, from Luke, and I'm going to read from verse 25 to 32. It says, and behold, there was a man in Jerusalem whose name was Simeon, and this man was just and devout, and he was waiting, he was eagerly anticipating, he was expecting, he was hoping for the consolation or the consoling of the nation of Israel. And it had been revealed to him by the Holy Spirit that he would not see death before he had seen the Lord's Christ. Then it says, so he came by the Spirit into the temple, and when the parents brought in the child Jesus to do for him according to the custom of the law, he took up in his arms and he praised God. You see, here was this man Simeon. The Bible says here briefly, he was righteous, he was devout, he was a really, really good guy, and he was waiting, what he was waiting for was the consoling or comfort for the people of Israel. You see, at that time, it was a really hard time in that nation. They'd lost all their political independence, everything was going wrong. They were living in fear of that cruel, crafty King Herod, which we'll hear more about later. And the people of Israel at that time were wondering if the Messiah was ever, ever going to come. But this man, Simeon, he was confident because God had told him, you're going to see him before you die. So he was confident. So here he was waiting, anticipating, and expecting this comfort. You know, his hope was that the Messiah was going to arrive on the scene and was going to turn things around. And you know, as I was thinking about today, it strikes me that many of us, we've got our list of what we're hoping for Christmas. I tell you, I made sure that I told Duncan this time what I was after. I wasn't going to end up with nothing ever again. So, you know, we've all got our list and we know what it is we're looking for. But you see, within every man and woman, I really believe that there is a desire and a longing and a waiting to receive comfort and consoling, exactly the same as it was for the people of Israel. You see, we can struggle, and many of us do, we can struggle with loneliness, we can struggle with desperation, we can struggle with just insecurity and emptiness. And in fact, it's proven in the Christmas season that it's one of the major crisis times of the year for depression and suicide, because